Here I'm sitting beside some of the most spectacular native orchids in Australia, and both of these are endangered species from the local swamps on the Gold Coast. And we've got them growing here at Griffith University. And this is part of us making the gardens as beautiful for everyone to come and visit and see. But it's also about conserving biodiversity. Globally, in Australia, and even locally, lots of species are under threat. And in the case of these beautiful faeus or swamp orchids, it's because of land clearing and collecting. And so we're contributing to their conservation through education and through working with local community groups who are propagating them with us and growing them up and then selling them on and releasing them back into the wild. One of the things we're doing in the gardens of Griffith University on the Gold Coast is showcasing some of the spectacular native plants that we can grow in our own gardens. And that includes this beautiful tea tree called Leptosperm Vertical Drop, and it just beautifully cascades down a wall. We've got other stunning ones up here, beautiful native vines. This is the Fraser Island Creeper. And the incredible thing about it is it's actually rare in the wild, found on and near Fraser Island. So this is the endangered Ormo bottle tree from Ormeo and by the Albert and Pimper River. And there are only 200 adult plants left in the wild. All of these plants, they're just spectacular and they're all native and predominantly from the local area. I'm standing in here in one of our forests at Griffith University. We've got 179 hectares that we're protecting. And this forest is doing so much for us. It's keeping us cool. It's giving a whole lot of biodiversity benefits. It's increasing our mental and physical health by being able to be in nature. But it's also sequestering carbon in these trees, which is really important, reducing our emissions, and conserving water and reducing contamination of our waterways with soil and pollutants. These forests are critical in our cities, providing habitat for so much biodiversity.